every bit of your blood cannot compare to one drop of the blood of the Lamb of God, which is slain.
Yes.
Every bit of that blood can't compare to the blood of Christ. Huh? Even though all those animals had been slain for years and years and years, those animals meant absolutely nothing because the perfect blood had not been shed. Think about that. This is why we have to sing songs like Take Me Back to the Cross. Nowadays we have all these shiny, pretty, beautiful crosses. Varnished, gold, silver, steel. Stainless steel. Lacquered stainless steel. We have all these bronze, all these beautiful, pretty crosses, but it wasn't a pretty cross. It was a rugged cross. It was a bloody cross. It was a cross in which the Lord gave his all. All that was human in him had to suffer, and all that was divine in him had to compensate. At this cross. This cross was an altar unto what God was going to do for us. Stand to feet, y'all. This cross was an altar what God, it was an example of what God was doing for us. Hallelujah. This in remembrance of me. And I go back to the Father and I send you the promise of Holy Spirit. For you have an overflow and anointing in your life as never before.
Yes.
An anointing that was meant to save the world. Anointing that was meant to not stay inside of here, but to go outside of these walls and minister the gospel of Jesus Christ to someone, because there's someone in your family that may even die on this week and not know Jesus. I can't do it no more. I can no longer go around and see people on their way to hell and not tell them there's a different way. There's something. There's something about the altars that we should go back and visit and we should build. Lest we forget. Lest we forget how good God is. Oh, the enemy is quick to want to make you forget how good God is. You forget how good God is. You forget how God gave you something to eat when you was hungry. You forget it real quick, real quick. You forget how God healed your body once before. You forget it real quick, real quick. Doctor give you a word and you're all worried about it and stuff, but what did God say?
Yes.
What did God say? That's the question. What did God say? It's not about what the doctor said. What does God say? Because God has the last say so. A fat lady can sing all she wants to, but if God did not say it was over, it's not over. This is what I'm talking about, by knowing how to appreciate and to reverence what has happened before you, because when you reverence what happened before you, then God remembers you and gives you more to brag on him about.
Hallelujah.
My. Hallelujah. Somebody need to understand what I'm talking about. Jesus hung on that cross. He hung on that cross where the sin kind of man was flung at him. Can you imagine? He hung on that cross where my sins and your sins came barreling through history and hit him. My sickness had been already healed in him the day before when he was beaten. Your diabetes was already healed the day before when he was in me.
Yes.
Your cancer had already been healed before the day he was in me. Your high blood pressure had already been healed Hallelujah. I can imagine, y'all. The sins of my past. Recent sins. Sins that I did on this morning. Sins that I'm going to do tomorrow and years from now. They came barreling through history and hit my Lord and Savior while he yet hung there on the cross and took all the pain that I was meant to take.
Hallelujah.
The sin was so great upon him that he had to say, "My God, my God, why have you forsaken me?" That's because God turned his head while Jesus yet hung on the cross because of the sin that was hanging on him.
Yes. Hallelujah.
Somebody need to know what I'm talking about. Bible says that remember the benefits. Don't forget the benefits. Don't forget the benefits. Lest we forget. Lest we forget. Lest we forget. If there's anyone here who don't know Jesus as their Lord and Savior, I'm imploring you today because the signs are in the north, south, east, and west. They're there. It's gonna happen, y'all. Don't fool yourself. Huh? 2014 years ago, he stood up before those men and he declared that I am the way and truth and the life. He declared that no one comes to the Father unless they come through me. He declared, hallelujah, that if you don't come through him, that you're going to wake up in hell, and God does not want you to be in hell.
Hallelujah.
If there's anyone here who don't know Jesus as the Lord and Savior, I'm imploring you to come forward right now. Come forward right now. Let's make this thing right. There's no reason for you to leave here not to be a part of the kingdom. There's no reason for you to leave here and end up dying and whoop, brother, untie your shoes tonight. There's no reason for you to go there, huh? God is speaking to your heart right now. If he's speaking to your heart right now, you ought to make a beeline up here because you know you cannot do it without him. You know that you cannot live without him. You know that you cannot make it into the kingdom without him. You need to make your way up here because this is not a game to play. This is some real stuff that we talk about. This is real serious. This is not a time to play.
Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah. Bless the name of our God. If there's not one, clap your hands for everybody.